I have with me the head coach of the Trinidad and Tobago men's senior team, Mr. Terry Fenwick, recently appointed head coach. Obviously, we all know that, you know, Terry has been around Trinidad and Tobago football for over close to 2 decades now, Terry.
Yes.
And finally, he has been given this opportunity to serve as the head coach of our flagship team, the men's Trinidad and Tobago senior team. Terry has been on the job now for approximately, would it be 2 months or so, and heading into what really is an exciting period for him in terms of two international games that are going to be coming up in March during the FIFA window ahead of the CONCACAF Gold Cup playoff against either Barbados or Guyana in June. Terry, thanks for being with us.
Pleasure, Sean. Thank you.
All right. So a lot of people have been asking, you know, very excited about your appointment and seeing the developments of the Trinidad and Tobago Football Association under this new regime. But of course, you haven't had the chance to really gather a squad together for either training or for any matches, but that opportunity seems to be on the verge of happening. Tell us, you know, what has been going on so far.
Well, first of all, Sean, could I just say the support on the ground has been overwhelming. It's been fantastic. Wherever I've been, all over the country, people getting behind, want to see Terry do well with the national team, because we've got such a big fan base on the ground. Whether it's the Champions League, Premier League, they all support, but they support the Trinidad and Tobago national team more than anyone. And I think the support base has been because of that. My early stages, obviously, this is about planning. This is about being structured and organised, making sure we're moving together along the right lines. Yes, I've been out there. I've been watching Pro League games. I've had a look across the board to see what we've got. I've been to training sessions with the under-20s, under-17s to see what the youngsters are offering further down the ladder there. And it's about pooling this information in, Sean, at the moment. Looking overseas, I've got other people out there scouting for me. I've got a whole heap of videos. I've now contacted over 16 players overseas that are playing at a good level, that have got Trinidad and Tobago parentage. So I'm now fixing the situation whereby I can then invite them to our next training camp and hopefully see them in games.
That's quite interesting. I'm sure people will be excited to hear a little bit more about that. Even though it may not be concrete, is there anything, any headway has been made with that? And are you excited about what could possibly happen?
Well, I am, but I think first things first, I think it's, I'm on a, almost on a daily basis, speaking to these guys over Skype. We're chatting about their games, their pre-seasons, wherever they are. Are they in mid-season? How's the league going? How's your performances? I'm speaking to coaches behind the scenes that are giving me an update on the individuals, how they're playing, what their form's like. So I'm piecing together all of that. I'm looking at different structures as far as my team setup, as to what players I've got for what positions. Clearly, guys, and everybody out there would recognise we've gone 16 games without a win. I'm not even counting Anguilla. You know, we need to be punching much higher than that. And I think by bringing some top quality players in, we have, and believe me, we have got some great players anywhere. But if I can fuse these new guys together with what we've got existing, the quality we've got, then I'm hoping we can then, step by step, get back to a top level.
As you mentioned, it's no secret that our record at the senior team level, basically at all levels, have been, you know, not very promising over the last 2 years or so.
Yeah.
What has the reaction been like from these players that you've reached out to, the clubs, players, agents, in terms of, you know, wanting to play for Trinidad and Tobago?
Well, the thing is, that was a big bridge that I had to get over, because they're looking at stats, and the stats are not very good at all across the board. But I think what they're seeing in Terry Fenwick is a new structure, a new way forward. I'm telling them it's about their profile. If they're not playing, I've spoken to 3 or 4 players that have performed at under 17 level, under 20 level for the US national sides. So they're playing at good standards. And I'm asking them, if you're not now getting into the national team of the US here, what's next for you? This could be a step up for your profile, get your name out there, get back on the international level, so you can move your careers on, and that's what I've done. I've made a pitch to them. It's not going to be easy, but if I get the right people, the right players, if I get the right structure about our team, and I play to the strengths that we've got, and all these guys are playing at good level, Sean. That's the, for me, that is the exciting thing for me, and they're recognising what I'm saying, This is a shop window. Bring yourselves back, international football, doing good things for Trinidad and Tobago. Get the country behind us. Start winning a few games. Get back on a competitive level. And then let's see where it runs from there. Because these guys, you know, there's no doubt we've got the oldest squad of football in football in terms of ages. I'm looking at 17, 18-year-olds that some of them are in Argentina. Lots of them are in the UK. I spoke to a kid called Phillips that's contracted with Watford Football Club only last week. And they're doing good things. Yeah. Now, when they come into Trinidad and Tobago eventually, they will not just bring their qualities as a player and the position they play in, they will bring that professionalism that the other teams and other clubs around the world give to these kids on a daily basis. That's what I need. I need us to take the game seriously. Here in Trinidad and Tobago, when the leagues run for such short periods of time, kids just, what do they do next? They go back to their communities. They're not professional. They're not treating themselves right. They're not eating properly, nutrition, all of that, which the rest of the world are really galvanized upon now. We've got to change that.